Said, thanks unto Jah, bless us for this night, when we dwelling together in righteousnessly. Teach us thy love and thy unity among all the nations of Africa. Thanks to be tonight, when the lady call us to be together. Almighty, bless this night. Give us the holy night. Bless us forever and forever. By the greatest name of King of Kings, Lord of Lords, the conquering lion on the tribe of Judah. Jah! Rastafari, Selassie, mighty Sila. Thank you.
You're a fan will now be a pro. You're a fan from the waist down, you're fine. Reside within my heart, you're fine. Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
Song as the bull, no, John. Song as the bull.
morning. I am excited and very, very, very happy for being here. It's a great honor because I've known Lizzie for quite some time, and it's nice to actually be at one of her concerts because she's always at my concerts.
Oh, wow. And what makes poetry special to you?
Well, when it's written from the heart and soul, there's no better way.
Yeah.
Sometimes a hand cannot touch where it needs to be touched, but words can do that.
They say the words are mightier than the sword, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. And so have you always been a poet? How long have you started writing poetry?
I've been writing from a very young age, but never thought I would be an author one day.
Yeah.
But through a very deep, painful, dark, broken history and a lot of rejection in my past, writings became my healing method.
Your therapy in a way.
Yes.
Okay.
And that's why my first book is called Never Give Up, Healing Words from a Poet. Because all the words that I've written actually healed me.
And what are you hoping to achieve with your poetry?
Well, there's so many unhealed people, broken people, unhappy people, people who can never find perspective of what happened in the past or can't forgive. I hope that the words that I'm writing, that whoever will read it, can communicate and find also the tools that I use to get healed and to be an overcomer.
Okay.
So that is really my hope.
And where can people find your books?
At the moment, my books are available at the National Libraries of South Africa.
Okay.
And I still need to do a lot of promotion, so at the moment they can order it from myself, from me.
Would that be social media, website?
Yes, you can find me on Facebook, Haroldine Chienda.
Okay.
And you can order from there also on my company's Facebook page, which is Lounge of Poetry.
Mm-hmm.
And you can order also order from there.
Alright, there you have it, folks, for healing poetry. It's Haroldine.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
From our own side, we're currently busy building our own studio to help other up-and-coming artists like ourselves produce, you know, to produce beats for them, to record for them at not a high cost, you know. So we all need to, you know, make a living, and also we strive for the same goal at the end of the day. So yeah, eFlow stuff will soon be on the market. It's not a matter of how soon, but we will be on the market. And yeah, if you want to contact us, you can go on to Facebook, you can go on to eFlow Records, and you just browse it and you'll see our stuff that we are currently doing. Then you can add yourself and contact us if you want to book us for any other event. But our music varies from any kind of style. We mix all different types of music. So people mustn't see us as hip-hop artists, they must see us as entertainers. Because if we take the hip-hop away, we can do pop music on its own, we can do rock music on its own, soul, jazz, even classic music. For rappers, it's a, you know, it's a very strange thing to do that. It's something new because not all rappers have that music skills that we got. But we came from the Marvin Gaye, the Panda Grass kind of vibes, grew up with them. So yeah, that's
I grew up listening to this guy's hip hop, my big brother. He's been, like I'll say, he bred me to be like this hip hop king, like this producer, the guy that came with raw talent, doing his own style. No copying, no imitations, just me being real. And I just feel that music should be done for the love of it, nothing else. Not for the money, not for the fame, just the love of it. Music needs to come from the heart at all times.
People to take away from the message that you deliver in your music and from tonight's performances.
All of the songs that we did is about women and relationships. And from, you know, like Secret Lover is the song where you meet this girl, like you always walk past this girl in the street. You don't have the heart to approach her, but eventually you approach her and you know, you guys click and you tell her how you feel about her. You just man up with the song of Secret Love. You man up and you go to this girl and say, listen, I really like you. Can't we start something? I really want to take this further. You know, I would respect you. You can introduce you to my to your family and we can take it from there. And I think he will explain what is She Keep Calling Me about.
She Keep Calling Me is about the girl that always calls you at night when you're like sleeping, you're trying to just get away from her and you are losing yourself to her. You're actually trying to stay away, but the feelings has grown so strong that you just can't leave her alone, you know, that you just keep on going and going. You tell yourself no, but you just keep on going to her. She keeps calling you at night, but you're just like, yo, I don't want to do this, but I'm doing it. You know? That's what the song is about. Yeah.
And the last song, Love is a Contest, like I told you. Love is always a contest between a man and a woman. You need constant work in a relationship. You know, there's no relationship in this world that are perfect. So we need to strive, you know, just to understand each other as men and women, to work at our relationship. We need to complement each other. We need to just level up on that same level. I need to be comfortable with her, how her attitude is in life. How, you know, we just need to come together and actually decide, listen, yeah, I'm happy with you the way you are. And we're gonna make this work as a couple. That's it. Just yeah.
Well, I'm sure all the ladies out there want to hear more. So, but thank you for being here today. And look out for E-Flow, and that will be Rickstar and Lyric.
Thank you.
Thank you. trying to get you there and the cameras, and wow, it is amazing. I can't wait to see the result of it.
And what does music mean to you?
Wow, music means connected. Music means, wow, there's something entrepreneurial about music. If it's from down, like at the ground, if it's grassroots, if it's the roots.
Yeah.
If you have to do it yourself, right?
Right, right.
But not only music, like what you do as well. I mean, doing it for yourself.
And what will be your